Singh verses about the Sky Ripper, but ancient codices held hints of other things. A stone that ate souls, a ruby that drank blood, a jewel only a righteous man could give away. Were all these things the Iblis Stone? Long hidden in a buried temple, another ancient item that was only resurfacing now, drawn up from the deeps by the Emperor's horrific rituals.
This chest was really awesome.
See what I did there?
Why would anyone put his slinky collection in a strongbox, thought Renardo. The magic slinkies? Oh, and there was something else. Renardo distrusted doors that opened automatically, especially after being buried for millennia. Was this some sort of trap? Ravens were already here, cawing in frustration. They were still searching for a way in. Good. And he hadn't come too late. Nice. That could be useful.
No!
your aerobics trait. Am I right?
Is a very cool sword, thought Renara. Yeah. No, seriously. He couldn't feel his paw anymore. Wait, what? How was he outside? Hadn't he taken an elevator into the depths of the earth? Felt like Tarzan. Used a hybrid propulsion system fueled by anti-gravity and wishful thinking.
Renata remembered when he'd first stolen one of these. Good times. How could a temple to Iblis still even exist? The transcendent emperor had destroyed all the shrines of the lost gods after exiling them. Had it been buried in that long-ago battle? Or had Iblis foreseen his fate and hidden it from his enemy? If they didn't want their things broken, they really ought to make them stronger. Something he liked to do, but only after he'd killed all the witnesses. This is why heroes are called dashing, Renato thought. See? Dashing? Get it? Ravens at least could not get past this point. Obviously, the temple builders knew how to deal with tomb raiders. It was a bit windy up here. It was a stone of the purest blackness. It reflected no light, like a void made solid. Nervous, he picked it up. Who said that? It was the stone. Eager. Thirsty.
Give the Emperor's daughter. Now you
That seemed tempting and terribly wrong. Zenobia was the Emperor's greatest general and a potent witch. But they had been close once. And Renardo wasn't sure he really wanted to be Emperor. Why not capture the core of Sky Ripper instead? It was the eye of a lost god torn out by the transcendent Emperor to power his greatest weapon.
Put the core,
said the stone anxiously. To a talking rock.
Ah, but the rock had a point. If the stone could truly turn him into a powerful warrior, he could defeat the Emperor with the very weapon the wicked old toad had sought for himself.
To be a hero, you had to sacrifice old friends sometimes, especially when they've become enemies.